Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices. O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. My song shall be always of the loving kindness of the Lord. With my mouth will I ever be proclaiming your faithfulness from one generation to another. For I have said, mercy shall be built up forever. Your faithfulness shall be established in the heavens. I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. Your seed will I establish forever and set up your throne from one generation to another. O Lord, the heavens will praise your wondrous works and your faithfulness in the assembly of the saints. For who in the clouds can be compared unto the Lord? And who among the gods is like unto the Lord? God is greatly to be feared in the council of the saints, and to be held in reverence by all those who are round about him. O Lord God of hosts, who is like you? Your faithfulness, most mighty Lord, is round about you. You rule the raging of the sea. You still the waves when they arise. You have subdued Rahab of the deep and destroyed her, and you have scattered your enemies with your mighty arm. The heavens are yours. The earth also is yours. You laid the foundation of the world and all that is in it. You have made the north and the south. Tabor and Hermon shall rejoice in your name. You have a mighty arm, strong as your hand and high as your right hand. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. Mercy and truth shall go before your face. Blessed are the people, O Lord, who rejoice in you. They shall walk in the light of your countenance. Their delight shall be in your name all the day long, and in your righteousness shall they make their boast. 4. You are the holy, you are the glory of their strength, and by your favor you shall lift up our might. For the Lord is our defense, the Holy One of Israel is our King. You spoke in a vision to your saints and said, I have set the crown upon one who is mighty. I have exalted one chosen out of the people. I have found David my servant. With my holy oil have I anointed him. My hand shall hold him fast, and my arm shall strengthen him. The enemy shall not be able to do him violence. The son of wickedness shall not hurt him. I will smite his foes before his face and strike down those who hate him. My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. I will give him dominion over the sea, and with his right hand shall he rule the rivers. He shall say to me, You are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation, and I will make him my firstborn, higher than the kings of the earth. My mercy will I keep him for him. My mercy will I keep for him forever, and my covenant shall stand fast with him. His seed will I make to endure forever, and his throne as the days of heaven. But if his children forsake my law and do not walk in my judgments, if they break my statutes and do not keep my commandments, I will punish their offenses with the rod and their sin with scourges. Nevertheless, my loving kindness I will not utterly take from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. My covenant I will not break, nor alter the word that has gone out of my lips. I have sworn once by my holiness that I will not fail David. His seed shall endure forever, and his throne as the sun before him. It shall endure forevermore as the moon and as the faithful witness in the heavens. But you have rejected and forsaken your anointed. You are full of wrath against him. You have broken the covenant with your servant. You have defiled his crown and cast it to the ground. You have overthrown all his walls and broken down his strongholds. All those who go by plunder him. And he has become a reproach to his neighbors. You have exalted the right hand of his enemies and made all his adversaries rejoice. You have turned back the edge of his sword and have not given him victory in the battle. You have taken away his glory and cast his throne down to the ground. The days of his youth you have shortened and covered him with dishonor. Lord, how long will you utterly hide yourself? How long shall your wrath burn like fire? Oh, remember how short my time is. Why have you made all people for naught? What man is there who lives and shall not see death, and shall deliver his soul from the power of the grave? Lord, where are your loving kindnesses of old, which you swore to David in your faithfulness? Remember, Lord, how your servants are reproached, and how I bear in my bosom the rebukes of many people. Remember how your enemies have reproached you, O Lord, how they have called after your anointed king with cries of scorn. Praised be the Lord forevermore. Amen. And amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of the Maccabees, beginning with the 13th chapter, the first verse. Simon heard that Trypho had assembled a large army to invade the land of Judah and destroy it. And he saw that the people were trembling and fearful. So he went up to Jerusalem and gathered the people together. He encouraged them, saying to them, "You yourselves know what great things I and my brothers and the house of my father have done for the laws and the sanctuary. You know also the wars and the difficulties which we have seen. By reason of this, all my brothers have perished for the sake of Israel, and I alone am left. And now, far be it from me to spare my life in any time of distress, for I am not better than my brothers. But I will avenge my nation and the sanctuary and your wives and children, for all the nations have gathered together out of hatred to destroy us." The spirit of the people was rekindled when they heard these words, and they answered in a loud voice, "You are our leader. In place of Judas and Jonathan, your brother, fight our battles, and all that you say to us we will do." So he assembled all the warriors and hastened to complete the walls of Jerusalem, and he fortified it on every side. He said, "Jonathan, the son of Absalom, and with him a considerable army. He drove out its occupants and remained there. Then Trypho departed from Ptolemais with a large army to invade the land of Judah, and Jonathan was with him under guard, and Simon encamped in Adida, facing the plain. Trypho learned that Simon had risen up in place of Jonathan, his brother, and that he was about to join battle with him. So he sent envoys to him and said, "It is for the money that Jonathan, your brother, owed the royal treasury in a connection with the offices he held that we are detaining him. Send now 100 talents of silver and 2 of his sons as hostages, so that when released, he will not revolt against us, and he will release him, and we will release him." Simon knew that they were speaking deceitfully to him, but he sent to get the money and the sons, lest he arouse great hostility among the people, who might say, "Because Simon did not send him the money and the sons, he perished." So he sent the sons and the 100 talents, but Trypho broke his word and did not release Jonathan. After this, Trypho came to invade the country and destroy it, and he circled round by the way to Adora. But Simon and his army kept marching along opposite him to every place he went. Now the men in the citadel kept sending envoys to Trypho, urging him to come to them by way of the wilderness and to send them food. So Trypho got all his cavalry ready to go, but that night a very heavy snow fell, and he did not go because of the snow. He marched off and came into the land of Gilead. When he approached Bascama, he killed Jonathan, and he was buried there. Then Trypho turned back and departed to his own land. And Simon sent and took the bones of Jonathan his brother and buried him in Modanin, the city of his fathers. All Israel bewailed him with great lamentation and mourned for him many days. And Simon built a monument over the tomb of his father and his brothers. He made it high, that it might be seen with polished stones at the front and back. He also erected 7 pyramids opposite one another for his father and mother and 4 brothers. And for the pyramids, he devised an elaborate setting, erecting about them great columns. And upon the columns, he put suits of armor for a permanent memorial. And beside the suits of armor, carved ships so that they could be seen by all who sail the sea. This is the tomb which he built in Modanin and remains to this day. Trypho dealt treacherously with the young king Antiochus. He killed him and became king in his place, putting on the crown of Asia, and he brought a great calamity upon the land. But Simon built up the strongholds of Judea and walled them all around with high towers and great walls and gates and bolts, and he stored food in the strongholds. Simon also chose men and sent them to Demetrius, the king, with a request to grant relief to the country for all that Trypho did was to plunder. Demetrius, the king, sent him a favorable reply to this request, and he wrote him a letter as follows. King Demetrius to Simon, the high priest and friend of kings, and to the elders and nation of the Jews, greeting. We have received the gold crown and the palm branch which you sent, and we are ready to make a general peace with you and to write to our officials to grant you release from tribute. All the grants that we have made to you remain valid, and let the strongholds that you have built be your possession. We pardon any errors and offenses committed to this day and cancel the crown tax which you owe, and whatever other tax has been collected in Jerusalem shall be collected no longer. And if any of you are qualified to be enrolled in our bodyguard, let them be enrolled, and let there be peace between us. In the 170th year, the yoke of the Gentiles was removed from Israel, and the people began to write in their documents and contracts. In the first year of Simon, the great high priest and commander and leader of the Jews. In those days, Simon encamped against Gazara and surrounded it with troops. He made a siege engine, brought it up to the city, and battered and captured one tower. The men in the siege engine leaped out into the city, and a great tumult arose in the city. The men in the city with their wives and children went up on the wall with their clothes rent, And they cried out with a loud voice, asking Simon to make peace with them. He said, "Do not treat us according to our wicked acts, but according to your mercy." So Simon reached an agreement with them and stopped fighting against them. But he expelled them from the city and cleansed the houses in which the idols were, and then entered it with hymns and song and praise. He cast out of it all uncleanness, and settled in it men who observed the law. He also strengthened its fortifications and built it in a house for himself, The men in the citadel at Jerusalem were prevented from going out to the city and back to buy and sell, so they were very hungry, and many of them perished from famine. Then they cried to Simon to make peace with them, and he did so, but he expelled them from there and cleansed the citadel from its pollutions. On the 23rd day of the second month, in the 171st year, the Jews entered with praise and palm branches, with harps and cymbals and stringed instruments, and with hymns and songs, because a great enemy had been crushed and removed from Israel. And Simon decreed that every year they should celebrate this day with rejoicing. He strengthened the fortifications of the temple hill alongside the citadel, and he and his men dwelt there. And Simon saw that John, his brother, had received manhood, so he made him commander of all the forces, and he dwelt in Gazara. Here ends the reading. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. Also in his riding, he is hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him, the God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. The Lord is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army is hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, the worker of wonders? You stretch forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. You brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Mark, beginning with the second chapter, the first verse. And when he returned to Capernaum after some days, it was reported that he was at home. and many were gathered together, so that there was no more room, not even at the door. And he was preaching the word to them. And they came, bringing to him a paralytic carried by four men. And when they could not get him near him, because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him. And when they had made an opening, they let down the bed on which the paralytic lay. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Some of the scribes were sitting there questioning in their hearts, "Why does this man speak like that? He is blaspheming. Who can forgive sins but God alone?" And immediately Jesus, perceiving in his spirit that they thus questioned within themselves, said to them, "Why do you question these things in your hearts? Which is easier, to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise, take up your bed and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralytic, "I say to you, rise, pick up your bed, and go home." And he rose and immediately picked up his bed and went out before them all, so that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, "We never saw anything like this." He went out again beside the sea, and all the crowd was coming to him, and he was teaching them. And as he passed by, he saw Levi, the son of Alphaeus, sitting at the tax booth, and he said to him, "Follow me," and he rose and followed him. And as he reclined at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners were reclining with Jesus and his disciples, for there were many who followed him. And the scribes of the Pharisees, when they saw that he was eating with sinners and tax collectors, said to his disciples, "Why does he eat with tax collectors and sinners?" And when Jesus heard it, he said to them, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. I came not to call the righteous, but sinners." John's disciples and the Pharisees were fasting. Then people came and said to him, "Why did John's disciples and the disciples of the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast?" And Jesus said to them, "Can the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast. The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and then they will fast within that day. No one sews a piece of unshrunk cloth in an old garment. If he does, the patch tears away from it, the new from the old, and a worse tear is made. And no one puts new wine into old wineskins. If he does, the wine will burst the skins, and the wine is destroyed. And so are the skins, but new wine is for fresh wineskins." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, you called your servant Luke to be an evangelist and physician of the soul. Grant that, by the wholesome medicine of the doctrine he taught, all the diseases of our souls may be healed through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, with God, now and forever. Amen. Set us free, loving Father, from the bondage of our sins, and in your goodness and mercy give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, you gave your servant Ignatius of Antioch boldness to confess the name of our Savior Jesus Christ before the rulers of this world, and courage to die for this faith. Grant that we may always be ready to give a reason for the hope that is in us, and to suffer gladly for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, with God forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Set forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another your abounding grace may increase among us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised that through your well-beloved Son, that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant the requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the Lord help us and enjoy the peace, believing through the power.